short weekend episode. Dr. James Beckett, Sports Card Insights. Going to the mailbag. I got an email from Ryan. It was a question about the BCCG episode that that I did a while back. And again, thanks Topps Panini Upper Deck, Heritage Auctions, Huffington Scott Auctions, Burbank Sports Cards, Mike Stadium Sports Cards, Beckett Media, including Beckett Grading, Beckett Authentication, and BCCG. It's kind of a quasi-sponsor, as well as CompC.com. So his question was, so he just got into collecting, and then he heard about BCCG, and he thought, well, maybe I should get some cards graded with BCCG. And he said he couldn't find anything on the Beckett website about it. BGS was all that was listed there. And then he tried to contact, but again, these day and ages, I'm actually being slow responding to Ryan's email, but the Beckett Media guys have been sheltered in place, and that place was not at the office for a while. I think they're back now, and they may get back with you. But again, just as a little addendum to the BCCG episode, even though it's Beckett Collectors Club, it's ironically turned out it's really not for collectors, and there's not a club. I guess we contemplated that in the beginning. It evolved into just purely a bulk service. So you can't show up and say, hey, I want to get one card graded by BCCG. It's basically for hundreds, or actually we intended it for multi-thousand card submissions with a lot of duplicates and a lot of, I mean, that's the only way we could pass through the price. In fact, I don't know that the price now, again, even in the old days, even though I didn't, this isn't my usual style, pretty much BCCG, every deal was different. So there were a lot of negotiated prices. I guess we didn't try to undercut anybody, but if somebody had X number of cards, that meant a certain price, but I don't know that we published it. So again, it's in spite of the fact that it's supposed to be a collector's club grading, it's really not intended for one-offs, or for if you have a special card. We, again, that's part of the confusion. It's really in your best interest for one card, whether it's a good card or not a good card. If it's worth grading, I would recommend going to BGS. Frankly, I'm not sure if you would think that, well, BCCG, that may be some way to skip ahead of the queue with the backlog for BGS grading. And I'm not the boss anymore, but I think the opposite might be true, is that BGS, if you were running a business and you had cards coming in, and some of them were going to pay you $30 to grade them, and some were going to pay $20, and some were going to pay $10, you probably, you know, with sound business practices, you'd probably want to do the expensive ones first. And BCCG would not be on that radar screen. So to my knowledge, it's still there. And if you write them an email and say, I've got 10,000 cards, I want to get graded, I want to do it with BCCG, and they're, you know, 1,000 of the same card of 10 different guys, I bet you'd get an email back right away, or a phone call, or they'd be very excited to have that business. But again, BCCG, not for everybody. I don't have any regrets that we started that, because I think it filled a niche. But again, this just points out part of the confusion for a decision that made sense at the time that is now almost 20 years. So Ryan, I recommend that you submit to BGS, one of my sponsors. They do an excellent job. If you use my name, it will not speed up your turnaround, because I'm in line with a grading order just like everybody else. So again, I hope that the world comes back to normal, and that and PSA as well can get back to better turnaround times, because it's good for the industry to have grading companies that are doing accurate work and timely work, so that the hobby can stay dynamic. So thanks, Ryan. Appreciate it. And sorry to be slow in getting back to you.